students, listen one thing. Everyone, every student, you will write your name, your name, your phone number, your roll number. Okay, I will give one Google form. Don't need to write. I will collect it. I will give one Google form where you will give your father's phone number, mother's phone number, your phone number, so that if you are any absent any day, then I can call your parents that you are not attending the classes. So Google form I will send today. You will fill up the form today, all of you, where you will mention your phone number, your mother's phone number, father's phone number, your mother's name and father's name. So I have to inform them that you are not doing the classes. You are so much busy in picnic or different things. So you are not doing the classes. So I have to report. So I have the attendance report. How many classes, for how many classes you are absent, every student. And what is the percentage of attendance in my class, I have to inform. So three students are absent today. I don't know the reason. So they should know, the parents should know. So you will get the Google form and you will write the phone numbers there and you will submit it today. Understand? So that when in internal marks you will get poor marks, then they should know, your parents, that marks for attendance you are going to miss. No need to come in college. You are present at home and you are still not doing your classes. So I have to inform them. I have warned you all many times, but you are not, all the students are not sincere about that. So I have to inform your parents that you are very busy in different works except study. So you will get the form. And you will submit it definitely today. So sharing skill, is it visible? Is it visible, this screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So yesterday I discussed what are the basic components of laser. What were the three components of laser? Basic components. Anyone say? What are the basic components of laser?
Ma'am, an active medium.
And the
pumping system. So these are the basic things that you need if you want to build one laser source. What is the method of pumping?
Ma'am, pumping is a process.
Pumping?
Ma'am, pumping is a process by which lower energy created to the higher energy system and it create a population.
Which one? The atoms present in the lower energy state are lifted to higher energy state. The atoms are lifted from lower to higher. This is the method of pumping. And what is population inversion? What is population inversion? Yes? Say by language.
When the number of atoms are higher in excited state than the ground state, it is called population inversion.
Okay. So population means the number of atoms present in any energy state. So the population of higher energy state, if it is N2, that is N2 number of atoms are present in the higher energy state. And if the population of the lower energy state is N1, that means N1 number of atoms are present in the lower energy state. Then in the condition of population inversion, N2 is greater than N1. So the population of higher energy state is greater than the population of lower energy state. But so this is the inverse condition. Actually, generally the population of the lower energy state is higher always. Generally N1 is greater than N2. But in the state of population inversion, it is just reversed and N2 becomes N1. Why we need the population inversion? Next question. Why we need the population inversion?
Because in laser, we require stimulated emission.
Because in laser, we need stimulated emission. And in stimulated emission, to increase the probability of stimulated emission, we need to increase the number of atoms in the higher energy state. So for this, stimulated emission is needed. What are the basic differences? What is the basic difference between stimulated emission and spontaneous emission?
Spontaneous emission doesn't require on the intensity of the incident.
Which one? Say again.
It doesn't depend on the spontaneous.
It means what?
The spontaneous emission doesn't depend on the in the incident.
Incident light energy.
Oh. Yes, ma'am.
But stimulated emission, it depends. Another difference that is very important. The photons emitted in spontaneous emission are
coherent spontaneously incoherent.
Incoherent. But in stimulated emission, the photons are coherent in nature. Okay. So these are the basic difference between spontaneous emission and stimulated emission. So these things I discussed. Now this is the ruby laser. I also discussed this is the ruby rod, that actually this is the active medium. And this two portions, end portions are flat. One is fully silvered, another is partially silvered. This is done to create the condition of optical resonator. Now here xenon flash lamp is there. From here, yeah, we are getting the incident energy. Now this is coated, that is totally covered with glass tube, and laser beam is coming out of this portion. This portion is partially silvered and this portion is fully silvered. Now I also discussed that is chromium atoms are playing the important roles. Chromium ions are playing the important roles because why we are doping chromium here in L2O3 to get the metastable state. To get the metastable state, because chromium atoms consist of energy levels including one metastable state. Not only one ground state and excited state is there, another state is metastable state, known as metastable state is there, which has longer lifetime than E2 and E1. So here in metastable state, the atoms will spend longer time and the stimulated emission we will get between this metastable state and this ground state. Metastable state is also excited state. This is also excited state, but it has energy less than E2. E3 has energy less than E2, but the lifetime of this metastable state is larger. So if the atoms are staying here longer time, the rate of stimulated emission will be greater, because it depends, stimulated emission rate, it depends on the number of atoms present in the energy state, higher energy state, depends on the number of atoms present in the higher energy state. So E3 is higher energy state with respect to G. So here the atoms are staying longer time, at as it has lifetime of the order of 10 to the power minus 3 second. It is greater than 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. So for this purpose, chromium is doped in L2O3. Now, same thing it is done. That is, when a flashlight of wavelength 550 nanometer falls upon the ruby rod for a short interval of time, the chromium ions in the ground state can absorb the photon. So chromium ions are absorbing the photon and makes the transition to the state E2. So xenon flash lamp, you know, from here incident light energy is given. And from that, in the chromium atoms, the in the active medium is in the ground state first, but absorbing the photon, that absorption process is occurring, and it is making transition from G to E2, from G state to E2. Now, since the lifetime of the excited state is very small, the excited atoms rapidly relax and drop down to the metastable state E3. Now, this transition is non-radiative transition, as the released energy by the excited ions being absorbed by the lattice in which it is embedded and gets dissipated in the form of heat. Since the lifetime of the metastable state is very high, the number of atoms in this stage goes on increasing. So the number of atoms here in this state E3, that is increasing. Now, in that case, the number of atoms in metastable state exceeds to its ground state. So the number of atoms in the present in the metastable state, it exceeds the number of atoms in the ground state. Here, the condition of population inversion is achieved between E3 and ground state. And that is ground state E1. Here, ground state energy is shown here as E1, excited state here, one of the excited state E2, and the metastable state is E3. So population inversion is achieved between E3 and E1. After achieving population inversion in metastable state, one or two photons emitted spontaneously and can induce stimulated emission, and the light amplification will occur. The transition from M to G, that is from metastable state to G, radiates photon, which after repeated reflection by the mirrors of the laser cavity amplifies largely to an intense beam. I discussed the property of optical resonator. By the successive repeated reflection between the two mirrors, the number of photons are increasing, and hence an intense, highly directional, coherent beam of light, lambda, remember this one, lambda, 694.3 nanometer, nanometer means 10 to the power minus 9 meter, emerges from the partially silver end of the ruby rod as a laser beam. So you can see, this is the partially silvered portion. So this is partially silvered portion. From this side, laser beam is coming out, and from this portion, we will get the laser beam. And the question may be given, what is the type of the, what is the color of the light that you will get from ruby laser? That is the red light. What is the wavelength of the order of 694 nanometer? Nanometer means, you know, that is 10 to the power minus 9 meter. So this is the energy diagram of ruby laser. So this is very important. If in language, if you are not writing, then it is also okay. But you have to draw this diagram and then briefly explain what is this. D1 is the ground state, E2 is the excited state, M is the metastable state. First, the chromium ions getting energy from the flash lamp. It is excited to the higher energy state E2. But here the lifetime is very less, that is 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. So the atoms can't stay longer time. It will drop down. It will try to come to the ground state. But in between, as there is metastable state, that atoms are trapped in this state. And here the lifetime is 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. So the atoms are staying here longer time. So the population inversion now achieved between E3 and E1. So we will get the lasing action here. And the color we will get from ruby laser, that is laser beam, as red color. So this is the energy diagram, and this is about the ruby laser. Now next, helium neon laser. This is another laser. Helium neon laser is the first gas laser developed by Ali Jevon and his co-workers in 1961. It is one of the most popular continuous wave lasers. It consists of a long, narrow discharge tube containing a gas mixture of helium and neon in a ratio of 5:1. So helium and neon, they are mixed in the ratio of 5:1. The electrodes are connected to a high voltage DC source. So here, this is the discharge tube where helium and neon gas mixture is taken in the ratio of 5:1. So the active medium here in helium neon laser, what is the active medium? Solid, liquid, or gas? The active medium for helium neon laser, is it solid, liquid, or gas?
Gas.
Yes.
Yeah. In ruby laser, what is the active medium? Solid, liquid, or gas?
Solid.
So ruby laser is a solid state laser and helium neon laser is a gas laser. And helium neon ratio is 5:1. Now, a pair of mirrors that you know to create the condition of optical resonator, a pair of mirrors are there, one of the which is perfectly reflected and another is partially reflected, continues the resonator system, constitutes the resonator system. The end windows of the tube are made optically flat and set at the Brewster's angle. It minimizes the unwanted reflections from the window of the tube and makes the output plane polarized, which is highly useful in many applications. Now, this is the energy level diagram on helium neon laser. There is a close coincidence of energy between two metastable states of helium and the excited state of neon. At first, the helium atoms in the ground state are easily excited to the metastable states by collision with the first discharge electrons. A direct radiative transition from these states to the ground state is forbidden. When helium atoms in the metastable state collide with heavier neon atoms in the ground state, the neon atoms are excited to 2s and 3s states while the helium atoms return to the ground state. Now, this is the energy level diagram. This is the energy level diagram for helium atoms, and here it is for neon atoms. So, helium, that is, here it is written. At first, the helium atoms in the ground state are easily excited to the metastable states. So, here it is the ground state for helium. It is excited to these states from ground state to metastable state. Now the helium atoms in the metastable state collide with the heavier neon atoms in the ground state. Now the helium atoms are raised from ground state to metastable state. Now the helium has higher energy because they are staying in metastable state. Now the helium atoms in the metastable state, they collide with the heavier neon atoms in the ground state. So neon, that is, this is the energy level. They are colliding with the neon atoms in the ground state. And what is happening then? That any atoms, neon atoms, are excited to 2s and 3s states. So this is the energy level of neon. It is excited to 2s and 3s state. So this portion is the energy level of neon. So getting the energy from helium atoms, neons are excited and it is going to 2s and 3s energy states, while helium atoms returns to ground state. At first, helium is excited from ground to metastable state. Then what is happening? From getting energy from this helium atoms, neons are excited to 2s and 3s and helium, it comes down to the ground state. These higher neon states are metastables and quickly attains population inversion. So actually the neon atoms are present in now 3s and 2s energy levels. These higher neon atoms are metastable. So this is the metastable states for neon and quickly attains population inversion relative to lower 2p and 3p states. Now here 2p state is here and 3p state is here. So you can see from here, as these are the metastable states, and this is, these are lower energy state with respect to this 2p and 3p. They have lower energy with respect to 3s and 2s. So population inversion is achieved between them. Now the transition from 3s level. So the transition, you can see from the figure, the transition from 3s level to 3p level, one transition is there, and another transition, three transitions are shown, from 2s to 2p, from 3s to 2p, and from 3s to 3p. So these are the different transitions. Now from upper 3s level, it is 6328 angstrom. You can see here, from 3s to 2p, when transition is there from metastable state to this, then you are getting this emission, 6328 angstrom. Radiations are emitted of wavelength 6328 angstrom, and it is 3.39 micrometer. Mu m means micrometer. So this is shown, 3.39 micrometer. So this radiation is occurring when transition from metastable state 3s to 3p. And another transition is there from 2s to 2p, that is 1.15 micrometer. So actually this is the energy levels of neon atoms. And in this case, from the metastable state to these three states, you will get the transition. If you get the transitions, then these are the emitted radiation of different wavelengths. Now transition from 2s level generates radiation of wavelength, that is written here, 1.15 micrometer. The bright red, that is 6328 angstrom line, is most popular. So this is the our desired radiation, that is in, it is found between which state? It is 3s and 2p. So it is from 3s and 2p, just note down this. So we will get the red light. So transition from 2s level generates radiation of wavelength this, and the bright red 6328 angstrom line is most popular. Helium neon laser operates in, so just remember up to this. So the light, the radiation that we'll get from helium neon laser has wavelength 6328 angstrom. And we will get this from the, for transition from 3s to 2p level. So whenever helium neon laser is there, in by language you can explain, but energy level diagram is must. If you are also not writing details in language, but you are just drawing this and writing in short, that language portion also you will get full marks. But that is mandatory for rupee laser and helium neon laser. For both lasers, you have to draw this energy level diagram. So this is important, Einstein's theory of laser and relation between Einstein's AB coefficients. Now let us consider N1 and N2 be the number of atoms per unit volume present in the lower energy state E1 and the higher energy state. Just wait. So Einstein's AB coefficients. So Einstein's AB coefficients. Now what I have to, we have to consider, let us consider N1 and N2 be the number of atoms present per unit volume in the lower energy state E1 and the higher energy state E2 respectively. So these are the two energy states, E1 and E2. N1 number of atoms here, and here that is N2. So let us consider N1 and N2 be the number of atoms per unit volume present in the lower energy state E1 and the higher energy state E2 of the active medium. Now an atom may raise to the excited state E2. So you know that if an atom is present here, it can be raised to higher energy state E2 from the ground state E1 in presence of radiation of frequency nu. So if one photons, it has energy h nu, so this is the process of absorption, so that atom can absorb that photon and it can go to the higher energy state E2. Already I discussed the process of absorption. The rate of absorption is proportional to the number of atoms per unit volume N1 available for the ground state E1. So this rate of absorption, already you know, the rate of absorption is proportional to N1. Now if the energy density U nu of the incident light, now if this incident light has energy density, now, am I audible now, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, U nu, that is the energy density of the incident light that was writing. U nu. What is this? U nu is the energy density. U nu, that is the energy density of the incident light. So this is the energy density of the incident light. Then the number of absorption per unit volume, per unit time is given by, how it can, it is written TAB. So this is absorption. AB means absorption. So we can write it as B12 N1 U nu. We can write it. So what is TAB? TAB is the number of absorption per unit volume per unit time. So TAB is the number of absorption per unit volume per unit time. So these are the two energy states, N1 and N2, at the number of atoms present there. So atoms, if it absorbs the energy H nu, then that will go to the higher energy state. And if U nu is the energy density of the incident radiation, then we can write the number of absorption per unit volume per unit time. Now I'm coming here. Number of absorption per unit volume, per unit time, it is given by this. And what is this B12? B12 is the Einstein coefficient of absorption of radiation from lower energy state to higher energy state. You know, absorption is happening from which state? From lower energy state to higher energy state. So absorption always, absorption from lower to higher. So it is written, one means lower and two means higher. So this is the Einstein coefficient of absorption from lower energy state to higher energy state. So you know, absorption depends on two things. What are the two things? Number of atoms present in the lower energy state and also on the energy of the incident light, okay? Also depends on the energy of the incident light. So actually absorption are proportional to this, N1 and U nu. So that is TAB is proportional to N1 and TAB is also proportional to U nu. Now we can write one constant. So that is the Einstein absorption coefficient. I'm writing like this. Now this is B12. So B12 is the Einstein's coefficient of absorption from which state? From lower energy state to upper energy state. One is from lower energy state and two for higher energy state. Now going to next one. So this is, now, what is written here? We know the spontaneous emission. Now I'm coming to spontaneous emission. Now this is about absorption. Now if we write spontaneous emission, now TSP means spontaneous emission. So the number of spontaneous emission, that is per unit time, that is what we will write it as A21. And N2. Say, the spontaneous emission depends on which?
Number of atoms in the higher energy state.
So what is N2? The number of atoms present in the higher energy state. Okay, there are two states, one and two. One means ground and two means excited. So number of atoms present in the higher energy state. So TSP, spontaneous, it depends on this. So N2 is greater, so spontaneous emission is also greater. So only it depends, it doesn't depend upon U nu, that is incident light cube, it is not depending. And here, A21 again some constant, that is coefficient, it is known as Einstein's coefficient of spontaneous emission. So where A21 represents this Einstein coefficient of spontaneous emission. So A21, remember, this is the coefficient of spontaneous emission from which? From which state to which state? From?
Higher energy state to lower energy
state. Lower energy state. So this is the Einstein coefficient of spontaneous emission from higher energy state to lower energy state. So this is another equation. So what remains then? This one. Now coming to this. Now for stimulated emission. Now for stimulated emission, what we will see? If we want to write the stimulated emission, TST. Stimulated emission depends on which? The number of atoms present in the
higher energy state.
Higher energy state. Stimulated emission also depends upon the incident light energy, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is also depending on this. So these are the two things. Now again writing here the coefficient. So I'm just writing here B. So from where to where? B? 2, 1. Okay. So these are the, so this is emission, stimulated emission. This is spontaneous emission. Spontaneous, SP means spontaneous, ST means stimulated. So these are towards emissions. So these two are, these two are emission, and in previous slide I wrote that is absorption. So actually what is absorbed here and coming here, it will come down by emission to the ground state again. So what we can write, So we can write T AB that is equal to T SP plus T ST. So here total absorption is equal to total emission. Total number of atoms absorbed from lower energy state to higher energy state, again they will be emission. In the emission process, they will come to the lower energy state. So this is the total emission equal to total absorption. Now simply, I'm coming to the next here. See, these two are equal. So these expressions I have only written here. The value of this, the value of this, and the value of this. This simple mathematical calculation. So if you just calculate mathematically, you will get this expression. A21 by B12, N1 by N2 minus B21. Just take one pen and paper and do it yourself. You know the expression TAB equal to TSP plus TST. Just put all the values are there. Simply calculation, simple calculation, and you will get this step. Now, according to the Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, the number of atoms in a particular energy state at any time, that is, it is the expression N2 equal to N1 into e to the power minus delta E by KT. So this is by Boltzmann relation. We can write the relation between N1 and N2. It is like this. Now, what is N1 and N2? You know, it is written here. And also, you know, what is E1 and E2? K is the Boltzmann constant and T is the absolute temperature. So the population, the relation between the population in the ground state and higher energy state, or the lower energy state and higher energy state, it is given by this relation. So it is just written like this. So this one, N2 by N1, it remains as what? E to the power minus delta E by KT. And what is delta E? Delta E is E2 minus 1. The energy difference between the lower energy state and higher energy state, that is equal to H nu. So in place of delta E, I can write here H nu. So N2 by N1 e to the power minus H nu by KT. So just put it here. So here the expression of N1 by N2 is here. So just replace it, this value. So just replace this value here. So if you put, then you will get this expression. So just then what I have written. So I have written B12 outside from the lower portion. Then you are getting like this. A21 is also outside. So in numerator is 1. So it is in this form, uni equal to in this form. Now, according to the Planck's law of radiation, we can write, I will discuss it in detail later. So according to the Planck's law of radiation, the energy density of radiation is this. Just remember this formula. I will explain it later. The energy density. So from this portion laser, we have derived the expression of energy density as this. Now from Planck's radiation law, we have also this expression of energy density. I will prove it later. Now equation 1 and equation 2, they are same. So we can compare, and comparing we can write B21 by B12. See here. Here, this portion, e to the power h nu by kt minus this portion. See, e to the power h nu by kt minus this portion. So e to the power h nu by kt minus this portion. So this portion is 1 here. And here, what is here? B21 by B12. So after minus, it is B21 by B12. Now here it is 1. So B21 by B12 equal to 1. So B21 equal to B12. So this is proved. This is equation number 3. And also we have from here, what is the starting portion? A21 by B21. So here, this portion, this is A21 by B21. Just compare the two relations, 1 and 2. So A21 by B21 equal to 8 pi h nu cube by C cube. Now as B21 equal to B12. So we have proved B21 equal to B12 earlier. So A21 by B12 equal to this. Now in place of B12, what I have written? B12, I have written B21. So B21 equal to this. So two relations are here, B21 equal to B12, and another relation A21 by B21 equal to this. This equation 3 or 4 known as Einstein's equation. So remember this equation, equation 3 and equation 4 are known as Einstein's equations. So time is over. Actually, it is 10:55 and you have another class. So I'm not discussing today more. So today I have discussed up to this, and only in laser, only some problems I have given. Have I given this note, students? Have I given this note, these problems, laser lecture 3? Probably no.
No.
First and two I have given, no?
Ma'am, only first and second.
First and second. So third one that I am discussing today. So few problems are here only for the discussion. So next I will start diffraction next week. Okay. So diffraction I will start in the next week. And these problems I will also discuss. So if you have, I am giving the notes. So if you have any problem, you can also ask me. Otherwise, I will ask if there is any problem. So some, how many problems are there? Let me count. 1, 2, 3. How many problems are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 problems on laser it is given. Huh? 5 problems on laser. So I will discuss these problems. Only 10 minutes or 15 minutes it will take. Then I will go to diffraction. So the topic that is that I will start in next week, that is diffraction. Okay, so I'm ending my class today. And I will
thank you, ma'am.
Full form today. You will write your phone number, your mother's name, father's name, mother's phone number, father's phone number, everything I need. I have to inform them about your performance. Okay. So ending my class.